For example, we have a betting gloves. Let's go back. Example of betting gloves. You have exercise equipment or sporting equipment. What kind of sporting equipment has no reference that it is a sporting equipment of leather, of plastic, of metal, I don't know, of text, of text, of paper, whatever. It just says that you take any product and you use it in a certain way in order to perform exercise activities. Use provision, therefore, is not under the exception. So no use, but if you analyze under make, this is likely to be relevant. Next. Make sense, guys? Yeah? No use, but all make provisions. So made articles of plastics, articles of steel, articles of whatever. That's the point. The next one, it goes for the sets. Sets. You can purchase those together. It must be, what's the requirement for the set? Well, one of the requirements is it must be classified under two different headings. Headings. The next requirement is it must be for retail sale. So that means if you have a wholesaler doing the imports, and when they do the imports, they are not really doing it with the end consumer in mind. So it's not packaged just to go on the shelf to reach the end consumer, but they're going to bring this, and then they're going to, let's say, so they bring a set. But then the wholesaler will take the marker apart and take the eraser apart. And they're going to sell them separately. But they're going to bring them together. Well, what's the problem with that? If you're going to bring it like that, then it's not a set for retail sale. It may be a set when you bring it for the importation, but really, when the end consumer sees the product, they do not see it as a set. They see it as separately sold items. And that kills the purpose. So for sets, if you have sets which are classifiable under two or more headings, rule of relative specificity is not applicable. Not applicable. So in other words, the picture emerges that it's really helpful to start with the exception to see if the rule applies in the first place. And looking at the exception, we see that most of the products which are done under the make are not classifiable under the rule of relative specificity. You cannot engage in the analysis what's more important as opposed to what is. And sets, if it's a set, most likely it will fall under the exception, so you will not even get to that analysis. But look at the cross out use provision, right? Use provision can and often does make it to the GRI 3A analysis because use provision does not refer to the part of the component. It doesn't refer to the articles that are put up in sets for retail sale. What it does is it just describes the classification according to the use. So it's a domestic appliance. You use it as a domestic appliance. It doesn't say that you use it, it's a piece of metal with electricity running through it, for example. Or it's a part of a piece of equipment made out of, let's say, steel and made out of steel for telecommunication wave transport, right? So what, it's kind of difficult because you have use, and it's kind of difficult to compare use versus use, because usually the exception refers to parts, and those parts usually refer to the substance component or the material. All right, so now we have a toolbox. Can I take this off? Yeah. Okay. So picture this toolbox, which is called or the tool chest rather, which is sold in many home improvement stores, department stores. This chest consists of two parts. The top part, which can be taken off and used as a box, and the bottom part, which is used as a drawer. It has on wheels. It is probably designed for more heavy, for more bulky tools. So essentially you have two products which are combined in one product. They are classifiable under two different headings. So you have a toolbox, which is classifiable in chapter 7326, the one you carry. And the drawer is classified as furniture, steel furniture. So, the problem with GRI 3A, is because it's really like a composite good, it's like a set. So, we really, you buy it as a whole thing. You pay, so you come into the home improvement store and you try to buy this as a whole thing. But can you engage in GRI 3A analysis? Can you say, well, this is more specific, the furniture part, right? The drawer is more specific description than the toolbox description. You cannot do that. You cannot do that because this is GRI 3A. You want to make a comment, Sonia?
Well, I'm quite lost in here.
Mm-hmm. So, how do we classify? So we have GRI 3A, rule of relative specificity, right? First, very first question, rule of relative specificity. All right. So we have this chest. Mm-hmm. Right here. So we have this product. When you buy this, you cannot just buy the top part, and you cannot buy the bottom part. But you have it's a combination product, because you can take the top off if you can see there is a handle there. So you can take the handle and just put it in your car and just drive on in your business, leaving this in the garage. Or you can put it on top and use it as one tool combination. Chest, piece of furniture, right? What's the problem? The problem is you go to the store, it is presented as a set. Here I'm not trying to put it as a set, but I'm trying to say that you have a situation that one part refers to what? Let's go back. You have the toolbox which you take off. It is classifiable as articles of steel, right? Yes, it is classifiable because I checked the customs ruling. They agree with me. So it is classifiable as in chapter 73, 23, 26. Just that part if it was presented separately, right? The bottom part is classified as furniture, 9403. The main reason for the difference in classification is really because it has wheels. There is a provision that says that it has wheels. So what do you have here? You have two provisions. One refers to steel, right? Other one refers to not a product in as such, but it refers to the furniture, how it is being used. Right? But look at this. This part refers to the make of the component. So you really end up comparing use and make. What's more specific, use and make? But wait a minute, we cannot compare make because there is an exception. We must, if you have a reference to a part, such as steel part, we must regard them as equally specific to whatever else. And that whatever else here happens to be the furniture. Which really implies that whenever you have make, meaning article whatever, usually you can forego GRI 3A. That's the point of me putting it out there. Yeah? So what you do is you next dive into the GRI 3B and you say, well, this is essential part, right? And you classify that, but not under three-way. You cannot say this is more important than the other one. It's also important to recognize this methodology, this analysis, because sometimes customs give you the fact pattern and say, okay, which rule, according to which rule this product is classified. Sometimes they give you those questions. And without knowing which rule prevails, you'll be in the world of guesses. And with guesses, educated guesses are okay, but off top of my head guesses are not will not get you very far.
Between the GRI 2B and
all right.
GRI 3A.
Yeah, GRI 2B, we would analyze this and the 2B, but if this was in the same heading. It isn't too classifiable, if it's, so long as it's classifiable under two or more,
it moves to
three automatically. You have to, yeah, you have to.
In the GRI 2, mm-hmm. cannot be applied on the sets.
GRI 2?
No, right. Is it coming to a set automatically, GRI 3?
So the question is this, you have GRI 2, and you have a product that's coming in as a set. Can you apply GRI 2 to the product that is a set? Yeah, why not? Why not? So, two set, which one? 2B or 2A?
2B.
Okay, 2B. So,
2A is always be the essential.
Oh, 2A? No.
No,
I'm sorry, 2B? No. 2A, maybe. Because let's say you are selling sets of spare parts, which are incomplete. You have spare parts, right? So you send out like bunch of sets of spare parts, and those spare parts are essentially the complete product, right? But they come as a set, they come together. So I can kind of see one working with another. So you have incomplete article 1 and incomplete article 2, they're all incomplete, right? But you have to make a determination which incomplete makes the whole set more essential.
Which one is more important?
Yeah. Which one is more important? Yeah. 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 This kind of weird scenario, though. I mean, we're talking about the outlier. Usually, I haven't seen many questions that relate, combine both 2 and 3 in 1. Usually, it's either 2 or usually 3. 2 is much more rare than 3.